YouTube, what is up, family? What is up? Welcome back to the channel. Back with some of you guys' favorite content. Doing the reaction video. Not even going to bury the lead, because if you follow the channel, you know your boy was boots on the ground to watch the Washington Commanders beat the New York Little Men. Yes, we call them the New York Little Men over here on this channel because they don't deserve to be called the Giants. They're the cellar dwellers of the NFC East, the cellar dwellers of the NFL as a whole. So, without further ado, let's get into this video. But before we do that, be sure to comment, be sure to like, and be sure to subscribe. On the road to 2,000 subscribers, and I can't do it without you guys. So, go ahead, hit that subscribe button, flood those comment sections, and let's get into the video. Giants threatening. All right, so I'm not even going to be pausing it all day. Not even going to have this video be super long. But if you notice something that, or this highlight is starting with a play under center or a scrimmage play, and that's because we had our 100-yard kickoff return taken back by Austin Ekeler. And right then, I knew it was going to be some fuck shit. Y'all know if you're a Washington Commander football team Redskin fan, you know it's always some fuck shit going on with the officiating whenever we play the New York Giants. If you go back to 2022 with Terry McLaurin, the infamous was he on or off the line of scrimmage, I was like, here we go. John Merritt done paid the refs already. They done paid the refs already up there in New York. Because we know the Giants and the Cowboys run half of the league, damn near. So, just a little footnote, because that should have been in here as well. I think it was taken back by a holding call or a block in the back. A 100-yard kick return will not be shown in this highlight. One thing that really impressed me is that I don't know how the NFL keeps doing it. I don't know how they keep doing it. Making a 15-minute cut-up in a game where we didn't score any touchdowns. So I know this is highlight. So I'm curious to see what they call the highlight in this NFC East showdown. So let's get into the video. Good bubble pass. The Cliff Kingsbury special. Get off me. He's a magician. That's the most exciting negative 2-yard play I've ever seen in my life. If this was Sam Howell last year, this would have been a 13-yard sack. Sam Howell's going down right there. The line of scrimmage is right here. Like I said, a 13-yard sack. If this was Sam Howell, if this was Carson Wentz, if this was anybody else that we've seen don the burgundy and gold at the quarterback position in the last couple of years, this is a fucking sack. So this is the most exciting negative 2-yard game I've seen in my life. He just allowed you to stay on schedule and doesn't have you playing too far behind the sticks. Get off me. Whoop. Did y'all see my man? Whoop. Did y'all see my man do whoop? Whoop. That's a quarterback doing that. Robinson straight ahead. Weight room shorty. Brian run through a motherfucking face Robinson. Brian mini man Robinson. Good screen pass. Cliff Kingsbury stable. De'Ami Brown out there doing more than just running around. He's looking. Daniels. And those are the throws where you got to get rid of the ball, JD5. Those are the throws where you got to get rid of the ball, man. Those are the plays. You can't take any negative plays. We're in field goal range, so it didn't hurt us too much. But imagine if we had a guy like Cade York. We just gonna talk through these ads. Go ahead and hit that subscription button, hit that subscribe button, so I ain't gotta pay for ads no more. Oh, get off me. My man Austin looking a little shifty. We had them boys on skates in the first drive. I'm mad that we didn't execute and score a touchdown. And that was the theme all day. Fucking false starts and fucking penalties in the red zone. That was the theme all day. One reason I like to go back and look at these reaction videos is because, like, you don't get the emotion from watching, like, an All-22 film that you get watching the TV copy. And, like, this joint took the air out of the stadium yesterday. Like, and I'm getting reminded about how much I was pissed off when this shit happened, bruh. I'm just as pissed off as Jaden. Like, come on, bro. Like, what are we doing? I was in the stands. Like, come on, bro. Bro, what's up with this D-line, bro? What's up with this D-line? John Allen and Deron Payne out there getting fucking baptized. Look at y'all, boy. Ooh, okay. My man Big Uso. My man Big Uso. My man Frankie Louvu laying the wood. But I want y'all to watch Michael Davis because this was a theme all day as well. Malik Labor's running away from niggas on drag routes. Like, we got the slowest cornerbacks in the world. But my man Benjamin St. Juice did step up. Hopefully he comes up in the highlights. But Michael Davis out there dominating 24, looking like Josh Norman, not being able to run with Steve. Look at him. That's a DB out there fucking galloping. He looking like Bobby Wagner did last week. Like, we see why he got no snaps last week. Look at Michael Davis. Michael Davis does not want to be in the business of tackling grown-ass men. He need to go pick up pickleball or some shit. Look at him. Oh, my God. Devin Singletary gets New York on the board. But the Giants, great opportunity. So the Giants didn't have a kicker because a nigga pulled a hammy trying to chase down Austin Eckler looking like me out there running the 5K. But, yeah, so that's why the Giants had 3 touchdowns. Give me that. Whoop. That's Earth's daddy right there. That's Earth's daddy. Earth's don't it. That's Earth's daddy. All Diddy. Give me that. Whoop. Meet me in the weight room. Bruh.
Conclusive evidence that you'd overturn if you call it a catch by Hurst.
Give me that.
I don't think there's conclusive evidence.
And you got Moss. Would ever change. On my ESPN NFL Monday Night Showdown shit. I need to hurry up and get this video on so I can watch it. Again.
Robinson will get him with a big hole and he's inside the 25 of the Giants.
Good holes.
Jaden Daniels with pressure coming and
same thing. You got to get rid of the ball. Austin Eckler picked up that blitz. I know it was an all-out rush, but you got to find a way to get the ball out your hands. Thank God for Austin Seibert. Austin Seibert, whatever you want to call him. We back to driving Hummers through the fucking holes, huh, D-line? We back to having our defense look like the fucking expressway. During at 6 a.m. We out there just joyriding out that motherfucker, huh? Get rid of the ball, bruh. Pinnock got his ass bagged by Zach Ertz and said, no more. He needs to start balling.
And Daniels has room. Can he get the first down? Yes.
And I start having motherfucking PTSD out there baking in the motherfucking sun yesterday. At this very moment, I ain't even want to be there no more. I start thinking back to that boy from Waco, Texas. That former Baylor Bear, that former Heisman Trophy winner. Oh my God. You did not want to be a Washington football fan in this moment. Y'all know exactly the feeling that y'all had when y'all seen this. He out there writhing in pain. I was like, oh my God. My heart sunk to the bottom of my toes. I was my quarterback. Like, but he's a dog. He's resilient. He was able to bounce back. And yeah, this play is what changed everything for Jaden Daniels. This was his welcome to the NFL moment. Because that hit turned him into a pocket passer. And you'll see in these highlights. Oh my God. Listen, just hurry up and fast forward through this shit, bro. I start having flashbacks of that cold January night in 2013. That's probably the only pass that you're going to see from Terry McLaurin downfield in this entire highlights. He top 15, though, right? Get some. Yeah, I know we had holes that you could drive a goddamn Tahoe through, but the Giants had holes that you could drive a motherfucking cheese bus through. Like, it was two bad run defenses yesterday. Something that you're not used to seeing with NFC East football, if I'm being 100% honest. But I'll take it, especially if we're going to come out on the winning side. Then my man Cliff getting freaky with the good middle screen. My man Austin Mighty Mouse Eckler. I told y'all he still got the juice. Austin Eckler a little crazy too. I seen the interview he was doing. He a little cockeyed. Good block by Austin Eckler. Still can't execute in the red zone. Gotta settle for another field goal. So Washington is basically dominating this game, dominating the time of possession, but you gotta be able to execute in the red zone. I told you that was the theme of yesterday. Get off. Hey, Michael Davis, bro, get your ass out the game, bro. Go sit your ass next to Dan Quinn and y'all just go get the shit of Rocky. Y'all go ahead and work on some handshakes or some shit, because you clearly don't want to be out here. Like, Malik Davis, goddamn dog, this is a 21-year-old boy. You've been in the league goddamn 10 years, and he out here fertilizing your ass. Looking like the Titanic, man. Like, look at you, bruh. Look at you, reaching and praying. Like, you really channeled your inner Josh Norman yesterday. Like, tell me this don't look like 2024 Josh Norman. The Wash version. The Redskin version. I'll be like, help me on your Boston Richie shit. Wandale Robinson, they want to at least equal things up with Washington. Jones has time, airs it out. That's a nice throw and a good catch. Blitz is on, it's picked up. There you go. Hey, bro. What the fuck? I promise y'all, this shit is not on rewind. This is another play where Malik Davis made this nigga look like a goddamn fool trying to tackle in. Bad enough you let up the catch. 27 seconds left on the clock. Like, just tackle him. Make them have to waste the timeout. Keep the clock moving. Do what you gotta do. But nah, that's too much for you. You out there looking like Bambi. Bambi ain't got his legs out. Nigga on all fours trying to tackle Malik Davis. Nigga out there bear crawling trying to tackle Malik Davis. Like, are you serious, bro? For all y'all that wanted to know why Michael Davis wasn't playing no snaps yet last week, do you have your answer now? He sucks. He's legit ass, bruh. Like, he is not it. And Malik Davis is going to be a goddamn dog, but come on, bruh. Be a man. Man up. That Daniel Jones thought this was the 2021 Commanders defense right there. Jones pulls the trigger. Touchdown, Giants. Malik Nabers falls it into the end zone. Nigga hit the Dougie on us. I was hot at halftime. I was hot. It was hot as hell at the stadium. And we out here getting cooked by Daniel Jones and Malik Nabers. They ain't do jack shit against the Vikings last week. I'm like, come on, bro. I ain't gonna lie to the Dougie. The Dougie was a little sweet. The Dougie, Percy out there pointing like he made a play during a play that counted. The interception of me going out in the stat sheets.
always has. And another on-target throw to Slayton this time.
Make sure he can't hurt us with his legs. He's got such dynamic ability outside the pocket. So good challenge. Get the start on defense for that.
Thanks, Coach.
All right, thank you,
guys. Here we go. And run defense back to being ass. Like, what are Payne and Allen doing? I just got to watch Payne. Like, what are they doing? Like, what are we paying these niggas all this money for? Out there just getting stalemated. Like, all right, Payne got a double team. Allen just out there doing what the fuck? Out there overrunning plays. Like, that's not a good play, bro.
Pick up of 19, Devin Singletary. And they had success right up the middle. Fake to Singletary. Jones in trouble here, and he's going to get sacked. I think I maybe shouldn't have brought that up about the sack.
Hey, Cleveland Farrell, the only person. Celebration a little chat. See, Cleveland Farrell, the only dude that got sacks on our team. We got two sacks through 2 weeks. I know that's one of the lows in the NFL. Gotta be. Hey, my man Benjamin St. Juice. My man GQ. My man LaVogue. My man finally made a play. Oh, my God. Benjamin St. Juice made a play. And it turned him up for the rest of the half. Over there making a play in the run game with the peanut punch. He not paid to do that. He paid to cover. And he ain't been doing that for the last year and a half. But, hey, if this wakes him up and turns him up for the rest of the season, I love to see it. I love to see my corners tackling. Benjamin St. Juice finally playing like he's 6'3". Finally. It only took 4 years. Good peanut punch. Give me that. Zach Ertz ain't running after the cut. He was looking to see how fast he could fall down without making it look too wild. Look at him. He is not running after the cut. He's straight catching fall guy. I'm not mad at it, though. Get off him. Get off him. The Giants ain't want to tackle Brian Robinson all day. Kayvon Thibodeau, bum ass, was talking all that shit. Out there doing his best Chase Young impression.
Closing pressure and spun down by Micah McFadden, who had left.
Gotta settle for another field goal, man. Execution. Execution. We were supposed to blow these boys out. That's why I'm not too mad that it came down to the wire. Because if we score on even two of these drives and get touchdowns, this game is not even a contest. And I don't want to hear about how the Giants ain't have a kicker. Tell your man stop thinking he Usain Bolt running down Austin Eckler. What the fuck was he thinking in the first place?
With his defense saying, don't let anybody come in here. So they have to settle for three. On third and 10, four-man rush on Jones. And
I told you, wee-wee. He came to play yesterday. He could do all this. He could do all the celebrations he won yesterday. I don't even remember that play. It's been quite the first 2 weeks for Terry McLaurin. Now, how the fuck did he get out of that? Now, if Brian Robinson was fast, and he ain't run like he had a goddamn refrigerator on his goddamn back, that's a touchdown. I love Brian Robinson. If he was fast, he'd be a top five back in the league. But I got to see how he got out of this in the first place. I told you, brother, Giants suck. They don't want to tackle. Like, how do you let somebody get up out of this? Like, what if I told you that this play turned into a 40-yard game? Then that boy got the chuck. He's supposed to house it. He's supposed to get out there and house that thing. He's supposed to house that thing, B-Rod. He knew it, too. If Brian Robinson was fast, he'd be a top what back in the league. Put it in the comments. Mighty Mouse. I love Austin Eckler, bro. He's a nut.
Now third and goal. Daniels outside the pocket, throws for the end zone, and here comes a flag. De'Ami Brown. And Austin Seibert is good. Perfect today. Obviously get outside and run a little bit, use his legs, and he's done it to perfection. Jones.
Pitch and catch, you're going to get that against a talent like Malik Nabers. I'm not too mad at that. But I am mad at that bullshit, bruh. You know I got to watch Allen and Payne. Because at this point, they sounded like a law firm more than the top defensive tackle duo in the NFL. Payne and Allen. Look at Payne. Overrunning shit. Look at Allen. Missing shit. Getting the wash down. Man, what are we doing? Payne and Allen.
They blitzed 45% of the time last week against Tampa Bay and Baker Mayfield.
Best law firm in the DMV.
It's picked up, so Jones has a moment and completes. Neighbors trying to get closer.
At this point, I got tired of seeing fucking Malik Neighbors running through our defense. Shit was feeling like the SEC. Shit felt like he was going against Vanderbilt. Hey, bro, is Malik Neighbors like prime Marshawn Lynch, bro? Like, how hard is this nigga to tackle? Now, like, let me know. Maybe I don't know. Malik Neighbors is a stud. I had him rated right under Marvin Harrison Jr. coming out of college. But I ain't see him running through motherfuckers like Brian Robinson. Like, is he, like, what? Or are DBs just not in the weight room? Like, what are we doing? Ah, that's ticky tack. That's ticky tack.
Boy, you just feel it right now.
Let's see.
This
let's see.
Become the go-to connection, right?
I guess. He held him. He held him. I'm objective. We objective over here, bleeding BNG.
The blitz is on. Jones tosses.
Hey, bro. Mikey Sanders have been had his ass flame broiled the last 2 weeks, bro. Like, what is going on? I ain't seen none of this shit at Michigan. He looks like he's physically overmatched. And I know some of y'all was sending me the clips where he was playing with inside leverage on outside cover. That's his fault, bro. That's his fault. That he can't play a man straight up, but he don't think that he can play a man straight up. Like, what's going on, Mikey? Still got a lot of high hopes, but Wandale Robinson fucking sucks. The Giants were talking about damn near cutting him last year. You can't be getting cooked by fucking Wandale Robinson. I'm sorry.
The fingertips, Slayton almost had it. It had to be that kind of a throw. Kind of a flight simulator for quarterbacks. So it's giving him great progress from LSU to here.
There you go. Look at Kayvon. Nigga sucks. I know we ain't Joe Rob, but your ass, bro.
Bad call. Watch Drew Phillips right now to get picked. I mean, you're allowed to try to cover your guy.
Before yesterday, Kayvon was only good against the Commanders. So if he ain't good against the Commanders, he might as well be out the fucking league. Go look at the stats. I'm not lying. Give me that! Uncle Noah, give me that! Wide receiver one right there. That's wide receiver one right there. No high take. No hyperbole. All right, I might be sizing it a little bit. Might be hot taking it a little bit. But hey! Noah Brown was the best wide receiver in the Burgundy and Gold yesterday.
And it says it right there in the Oculus, and then you go through the play. Daniels will throw it back.
Oh, yeah. Cliff Kingsbury was in his Duffy. Get off me! Hey, what? I told y'all Austin Ekeler was a goddamn nut, bro. What the? This is like AB against that punter. He knew damn well he wasn't clearing him on his hurdle. He just wanted to do this. He just wanted to do it. He knew damn well he wasn't clearing him. Look at that shit, man. And how the hell does he end up on his feet? Oh, dense ass nigga. Like, oh, compact ass nigga, man. I used to hate playing against niggas like these, man. Niggas like goddamn bowling balls. Look at Brandon Coleman handling Thibodeau ass. Ain't nothing happening there. I just want to see y'all. I want y'all to see our rookie handling. Oh, is that Andrew Wiley? He getting handled by Andrew Wiley, my man. That's even worse.
A well-traveled kicker who's been busy today. It's true.
That was the best highlight of Washington Commander made all game. That boy Big Oss.
Just
straight, I told y'all that was the thing for today. Malik Neighbors running by everybody on drag routes. I don't know what the fuck Joe Witt Jr. was doing. Hey, dog. Hey, Jeremy Chen. I was hyping you up on this channel all offseason. And through 2 weeks, you making me look like a dumbass, bro. 6'3", built like goddamn Hercules. Built like a Greek god. Built like a Greek god. Got Daniel Jones, 1-on-1 in open space. And you fall to your knees like a fucking life alert, like a fucking life alert commercial, bro. What the hell was that? Fucking Daniel Jones got you out here breakdancing. Oh my god. What is that, bruh? Like, out here built like Zeus. Getting shook by Daniel Jones. Tighten up, bruh. Tighten up. I'm sorry, but if I had to watch that bullshit live yesterday, y'all gonna have to watch it again too. There wasn't no nice move. He just asked. Hey, Malik Neighbors, let me know the addy so I can send you the thank you card. Because, yeah, you threw that one away, buddy. I ain't going to hold you. Rookie, I get it. Second game, career game. You got to come down with those catches, buddy. You looking sad as hell. Pick your ass up. You weren't doing all that when you was hitting the dougie on this 5 minutes ago. Pick your ass up, bruh. Get up, bruh. Take this L, bruh. Because he knew it was Jaden Jackson. He knew it was his buddy's time to shine. I had you on my fantasy team, too. You gave me a good 24-point effort, though, so I can't do too much complaining. Ain't like I had Terry McLaurin or something. There you go. Wide receiver one. That was probably the best throw Jaden Daniels made all game. I told y'all that hit turned him into the pocket passer. Look at him stand tall in his pocket and deliver this throw over the middle. I thought y'all said he couldn't do that coming out of LSU. I thought y'all told me that he couldn't throw over the middle coming out of LSU. Told you, Cliff was in his Duffy. Cliff was in his big bag. Get going. Y'all see how he stayed inbounds, but he's so damn skinny, like they flung it. He tried to stay inbounds, but he's so damn skinny, they flung his ass out of bounds. Even Tavon Thibodeau, bum ass, can fling my man Jaden out because he built like Gumby. And that's the ball game. Not a sight too familiar. As a Washington football team fan over the last couple of years with us beating the New York Giants. But just like 2021, we beat them on a game-winning kick. And DeMarcus Lawrence is looking sad after, you know. 1-1. On to the Cincinnati Bengals. I'm super excited because we could be 0-2. And we could be the New York Giants. So I know this was an ugly game. Shout out to the NFL for making a 15-minute cut-up of a game with one team didn't score any touchdowns. It still got the win. Keep tapping into the channel. Reaction videos to come. If you haven't, go ahead and check episode 134 of the Bleed It B&G podcast where we talk about this game and give you the most raw, uncut, and unfiltered analysis on this game. And, yeah, I'll check in on y'all on the flip side. Peace.